So we're back at the composting area. We've collected all of the materials that we're going to use for our compost. Let's call it a designer compost for permaculture. Just remember, even though we're going to use a varied materials that we have on our farm, it's a big farm, we do a big garden. If you compost with what you have, so anything organic can be composted, and you make the best compost that you can make, okay? And then over time, you may start with this, and then you can develop more resource connections and get more resources, and you can improve your compost. A good diversified compost is going to have a diversified ingredients, and that's where we can have a different minerals in our compost. But before we look at that, I want to talk to you about where does the minerals come from in the first place, okay? So it's great to understand compost, but how do we get minerals in there in the first place? So in a naturalized state, we're under this large tree. The tree has a large root system. The root system will go down to the substrate or rock profile that's under this soil. So you have soil down to the rock profile. Different places is different depths, okay? The tree will then put its roots into the anaerobic condition. In an anaerobic, which we'll look at on another practical series tomorrow, in an anaerobic condition, the anaerobic bacteria can actually break rock down and convert rock into water-soluble minerals. So the minerals that we find in our vegetables get to the vegetable through the tree, taking the water-soluble minerals up through its roots that are being broken down in the anaerobic condition, through the tree mass, into the leaves fall down in the forested system. It makes the humic material. So this is the first step, trees creating the mineral cycle from our rock substrate. So the minerals present on our particular property are going to be tied to the parent rock material. So if that particular parent rock material was missing a particular mineral that we may deem as necessary, we could add those minerals to our soil. We'll look at that tomorrow in the anaerobic composting series, and how to add minerals. But right now we have these minerals. So this would break down. So if I compost this, these minerals will then become available in my compost to be put to my vegetable, so that I would have the correct mineral profile in my vegetable. The mineral originating at the rock layer. In a concept, what's a problem in the West or in Westernized or even around the world now, we're taking the minerals from our properties, we're eating them, and for the most part, a lot we go to the toilet and we flush our minerals down the toilet. They go out to the ocean and we dump them into the ocean. So we're demineralizing our soils. So a lot of the soils, it took thousands of years for the trees to create the leaves, to create the mineral profile that's in the soil that we now use in modern agriculture in order to grow our food. And every year, there's less and less minerals. So they can even do studies where they found, like you take, for instance, like broccoli sold in 1940 in the United States and broccoli sold in Whole Foods today. There's a 40% reduction in the minerals in the food, okay? So we've taken something and in a process of 70 years, we've demineralized our soil base by that 40%. If we continue to do that, we're gonna have ill health. Ill health is tied to mineral deficiencies. So almost all disease is tied back to mineral deficiencies. A really great book to read is called Soil and Cancer, where it's a veterinarian study that they did in France, where they would go and every time there's something wrong with the animals, they look at the food source. They find out that the animal's getting a mineral deficiency, at which time it causes the disease. They change the food source to add that mineral into the animal's diet, no drugs, and the animal recovers. If we're eating animals that are eating bad food sources and we're eating plants that are demineralized because the soil doesn't have the mineral profile, we'll be unhealthy also. So one of the problems with modern agriculture and the concept of organic is I go to the farmer's market and they have no concept of where the food was grown and is that farmer mineralizing the soil. So if the minerals are not present in the soil, the mineral cannot be present in the food. So you may have a tomato that looks like a tomato, and this tomato looks like this tomato, and they look identical, but this one had a better soil profile. It would have more minerals, right, for our health in this tomato. They'll look the same. They'll even taste the same. You can't taste minerals. So this is something that as a permaculturalist, we want to work on how to get the minerals into our soils in order to get them into our foods. So that's probably, for me, more important than any other aspect, even more important than whether or not there was pesticides on the food, guys, is whether it had minerals. Okay, first step. So we're going to work on that soil. So we'll look at composting. Tomorrow we'll look at how to get minerals.